A clip of the show was on the Howard Stern show. Very exciting. This was part of our interview with Pastor Manning. My disappointment is, and I'll play the clip, that it was not said, this is from the David Pakman show. People who already were familiar with my show and also listened to the Howard Stern show, which I also listened to, notified me and said, hey, David, I heard a piece of your Pastor Manning interview on there, but they didn't mention you. They didn't say it's from the David Pakman show. Better than nothing, though. Let's take a listen to the clip.
And what is this, the leap that now we're going to approve of people having sex with
right.
animals?
Well, if you open the door to gays, then you've got to say, well, it's not constitutional to keep people from getting married who want to marry a horse.
The gays and lesbians want to control everything. This is part of...
Control everything.
What are they controlling?
I don't know.
Nobody's in control of anything.
Well, this sounds like, you know, Hitler with Jews and... You know, it's just like a stereotype. They're out to get us. They're going to take over the world if we don't stop them.
Actually, I was looking at whose campaign slogan, Rand Paul. His campaign slogan is Take Back America. Who's got it right now?
Yeah, I think Rand Paul's got it.
The left-wing agenda to do away with Christian values and substitute for Christian values the... Well, what is it? Progressive concepts of morality.
I can't wait to start fucking animals now that I've approved of gay lifestyle.
Once it's okay, you're certainly going to do it, aren't you?
Yeah, Pastor Manning went berserk. You want to hear some of his stuff?
Sure.
Yeah, he's very comfortable with the word faggot and
just every awful word.
Pastor, here's what you got. You got to get up there in the pulpit and call people faggot. You got, they don't like it. God knows they don't like that because they know it's a despicable. They know it's a dirty toilet bowl word. They don't like it. They don't call it to them. Say it loud. Faggots! Say it. They don't like it because their lifestyles are dirty. They want you to say something nice like gay when they're really faggots. Bulldaggers. Hermaphrodites. Lesbos! Queers!
I think he's gotten lost his mind.
Oh, he's having a ball.
Yeah. But he says he was in prison and was tempted with gay sex.
Oh, then he's got a problem.
I think that you admitted in an interview with Jenk and Anna over at the Young Turks that at one point you yourself were tempted by what you call the gay lifestyle. What? Tell us about that.
I don't know about the gay lifestyle. That's an addition. I was in prison in my early 20s, and yes, I was tempted to engage in a sexual intercourse with a sodomite. No doubt about it. Yeah, I did. I didn't do it. Listen, I thought about it at one point in time while I was in prison of committing suicide. I didn't do that either, but I was tempted.
But what were your temptations brought on by? In other words, you're in prison, you considered yourself, I assume, a heterosexual male, and what happened that made you say, maybe I'll have the gay intercourse?
The man had a beautiful cock.
Been a long time without a woman. That's what it was. It was a long time without a woman. And, you know, it just...
I don't know. I still think if I didn't have a woman for the rest of my life, I still wouldn't fuck a guy.
Oh, well, I don't know that you can say that.
I think I can with some confidence. I think this
no,
guy...
No, you haven't been in prison where you're just surrounded by men and there's nobody else and no end in sight.
Mm-hmm.